best articulation and most advertised articulation is the Sustainable Development Goals. Sustainable Development Goals, which began, which was sort of inaugurated in 2015 as the 2030 Agenda, talks about you know, profits and people, not just profits. It's not simply about economic growth, but also about decent work as part of economic growth. And unlike its previous avatar, which was the Millennium Development Goals, the SDGs are very aware that this is not something that simply governments can do. It takes, it brings into, you know, as key stakeholders, companies and businesses, because, you know, as drivers of growth, they have a huge role to play. I think it's also, you know, fair to say that businesses have taken this on quite wholeheartedly. There's often a lot of talk about businesses, you know, quoting the 13 trillion opportunity that SDGs present. But to sort of, you know, push that envelope further, perhaps this conversation today could also talk about not just the role of business in sustainable development, but also the responsibilities that businesses have towards sustainable development. I am flanked on both sides by panelists who represent different parts of the business community. I would request you to begin, you know, start from this side, your opening remarks on the topic, and perhaps give a brief introduction without taking too much time. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, thank you, Tis, for giving this opportunity to us. I welcome the panelists also for a healthy debate on the issue. Well, as far as you know, this topic is concerned, making businesses responsive, right? So obviously, the first context which is coming to my mind is the sustainable development, you know, which everybody is aspiring for these days. I think, you know, earlier, you know, there was a Millennium Development Goal, right, which was framed, there were 8 goals, you know, which were under the Millennium Development Goals. But in 2015, this exercise was done by the UN General Assembly when they framed the new Sustainable Development Goals, which were 17 in number, and the last one was about the partnering, you know, partnerships, you know, for achieving these goals. So basically, the last one is the collaboration part, and the rest of them are the key focus areas. Just like in a performance management system, you have KRAs and the KPIs, and then you have the final, you know, measurable index on that. So, the very important part is that, you know, almost 193 countries have, you know, adopted this sustainable development goals. And you know, everybody has committed themselves for you know, making sure that these are achieved by within a deadline of 15 years, which is expiring on in 2030, I believe. So to ensure that, you know, these goals are also measured, UN also came up with, you know, SDG index on which different countries are being ranked. If I look from the India's context, I believe it is not even in the top 100. Right, so you know, there's a huge gap in what we aspire for and what is the reality. Let us look at some of the startling facts which are very important to mention is in this August halls. Our current human development index, that is, you know, as far as India is concerned, we are placed at 130, I believe, out of 150 plus countries or economies. This is a report which is published by the UN Development Program. And a second major report which came up recently was gender you know, equality report, right? So there also, India is not doing that great. So we are, I think, placed at close to 112. There's a huge, you know, disparity in the inequality in the gender parity. And I think it will take more than 100 years to reduce that gap from an economic perspective, from a health perspective, from an education perspective. And third, very important report which came in was the Global Hunger Index, where India ranks close to 102, I believe. And we are placed even lower than Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Nepal. So this is the context, you know, within which I think we need to, you know, deliberate. I will request all the, you know, panelists to maybe throw some light on this. Why, you know, we have all these goals in mind, but at the same time, the dark realities are hitting you very hard. I think Professor Kannan also earlier, you know, mentioned about the wage inequality, and that is getting deeper and deeper. So, you know, there's a larger responsibility for not just for the corporates, but I believe for even for the informal sector also to take on the responsibility to ensure that all these goals are met. The primary goals are, you know, related to hunger, that, you know, zero hunger is one of the goals, poverty eradication is one of the goals. Then you have innovation, infrastructure is also one of the goals. Decent work, as you mentioned, sir, which is also a very important convention of ILO, that has also been included into the goal. So there's huge responsibilities on the corporates as well. Now, as far as India is concerned, now just having a sustainable development goal is not good enough. There has to be a transition of these goals into your legislations, into your policy framework, and, you know, thereby and subsequent, you know, the, you know, measurement of the same. So the government of India has, you know, initiated this this entire, you know, process by formulating a new body called as Niti Aayog, right, which is actually, you know, cascading the entire implementation part of the SDG. In India, you know, currently Himachal, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, they are among the top, you know, performing states. But there are 14 states which has fallen below even their earlier, you know, level as far as sustainable development goals are concerned. Recently, Haryana has become the first state in the country which has aligned its budget along with the sustainable development goals. So I think, you know, this is just context. I'm just maybe, you know, floor is open for the comments. This much is initial remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Yashwant, because you have taken a lot of load from us. A very good afternoon to all of you. The topic for today's discussion is making business responsible. Is business irresponsible? Is business irresponsible to whom? If it is irresponsible, to whom? Yashwant, you have said, yes, there are lots of things to be done. But I think we are progressing. Let's be positive. We are progressing. For example, if you see the Niti Aayog report of 2018 and 2019, the SDG rank, I think it improved from 57 to 60. Small increase for a big nation. It's really a small. But then we have to realize that, yes, for business to prosper, we need to work on these SDG goals. The government, on its part, it also has a big role. It has to align its budget towards that. The policies needs to be like in line with those goals. From a policy perspective, if you see various policies like Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, or Ayushman Bharat, or Pahal, or Ujjwala, these are all these schemes are in that direction only. But government cannot do everything. The business has to come out. And now, why should the business come out? Business has to realize that through these goals, ultimately the objective of business is still profit maximization. Yes, profit maximization can happen if there is a demand in the market. And demand creation can happen only when the society
there is a development in the society, there is an income generation, there is poverty alleviation, zero hunger reduction, inequality reduction. So all these things indirectly will ultimately help in the industry's growth, business growth. So from that perspective, I think business, from its self-interest point of view, should also look at SDG goals and should take up issues in its own area of influence and try to do something. I mean, otherwise, you see, in India we have always done business in India, in traditional India, or for that matter, for example, Tata, why did they set up this institute? There has to be some contribution from business towards these goals. With this, I conclude myself.
Setting it up?
No, it's here.
It's here? Okay.